The pre-budget dialogue, organized by members of civil society, has been held under the theme, repurposing the 2024-2025 budget. What are the key priorities for inclusive economic growth and service delivery? This dialogue, which has been held in Kampala, attracted budget advocates and experts, academia, and government officials, especially those from the Ministry of Finance. The budget experts expressed the need for the government to consider doing away with some expenses, such as travels abroad, special meals, ceremonies, and state house functions, among others. They are optimistic that the government will be able to save huge amounts of money once this is put into consideration.
Travel abroad, you have 90 billion in this financial year 2023, and you are planning to spend 108 billion in 2024-2025. And we are saying this one, if you can get half of that, 54 billion can be saved. Travel inland too, we say that you have budgeted for 587, but you are proposing to increase it to 671.
The panelists also decried the increased debts, corruption, and what they termed as the frequent supplementary budgets.
The appetite, but also what Dr. Mkunda told us here, that actually we contract loans, we don't use the money. What is that? We contract the debt, we don't use the money, and the interest on the loan grows and we have to pay. You need to calculate for us, Dr. Mkunda, how much Uganda is owed? How much? And you could calculate that one. This debt we have, how much each Ugandan, even a poor person somewhere, is owed because of failure of our people to contract responsibly and service responsibly.
In response, the Minister of Finance, Matia Kasaija, gave confidence to the public that the economy is steadily growing. What is needed is for the people to look into new ventures where they can get money, invest it, but also do some savings.
Money will never be enough. You young people, I'm telling you. It will not. Even now, if you give me now another 50 trillion shillings in the budget as we move now, it will not be enough. That's when we shall think to do this, we shall go to do this, there is a road there, there is an airport there, there is salaries, increase in salaries. So money is never enough. But how, as an intelligent people, how do we manage? We prioritize.
He argued that money will never be enough, and this is why government is still focused on allocating funds to only areas which matter to the ordinary people. Responding to the concern of the growing public debt, he reiterated that he will not borrow indefinitely to mortgage the country.
Not borrow indefinitely. Me, as long as I'm your Minister of Finance, I will not borrow indefinitely to mortgage your country. That I will never do. Many things, it's not a matter of life or death. There are certain things we can postpone. There are certain things which we can defer.
Report by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.